The Nigerian Association of Resident Doctors has threatened to begin another nationwide strike starting September 7. The association, in a statement signed by the President, Dr. Aliyu Sokumba, and Secretary as well as the Publicity Secretary, said the strike would commence after the 21-day ultimatum it gave to the federal government elapsed on August 17. The doctors are demanding from the federal government the implementation of residency funding, COVID-19 allowance, hazard allowance, as well as the outstanding salary shortfall of 2014, 2015 and 2016. On June 15, the association had embarked on an indefinite strike. The strike was suspended on June 22 after the intervention of the federal government and other stakeholders in the health sector. We're now joined by Dr. Stanley Ebeogu, the PRO, Nigeria Association of Resident Doctors. It's a pleasure to have you join us on the news. Let me just put you on the spot. 2 months, that's the period it's taking for NAD to embark on yet another strike. Will this resolve the issue?
Well, thank you for having me. I believe that strike is not the only way to resolve an issue, but the current government we are facing now has shown us that that's the only way they want issues in the health sector to be resolved. Recall that it was when we went on strike on the June 15th that they went ahead and paid April and May COVID inducement allowance. And immediately we called off that strike, the payment stopped. As we speak now, we've not received anything for June, July, August, and now we are in September. And in the initial agreement we had with the federal government, it was stated clearly that by September, a new reverse hazard allowance will be determined for the association and for all health workers in Nigeria. And as we speak now, nobody is even talking about what is our hazard allowance. Our hazard allowance has remained the paltry sum of 5,000 naira as we speak now. So we believe that since the government has refused to call us to meeting to have negotiations with us and determine these things, we decided that we can no longer tolerate this, and we have decided to down tools on Monday.
Again, the question of the Hippocratic Code, oath rather, that you take when you swear to become a doctor, people would say it's in variance to that because your primary responsibility is to care for patients. Where does that leave your patients now?
Thank you for that question. You know, the reverse Hippocratic Oath also stated clearly that a doctor or a health worker would also be in good health and a sound mind in order to be able to take care of his or her patient. And if a doctor is not well paid, if a doctor is not well taken care of, I don't see the reason why the doctor will continue to work. And the truth be said here is that even as we have been fighting this COVID-19 pandemic, some of our members have lost their lives. And as we speak now, there is no death in service benefit for all those people. We don't even have group life insurance for all our health workers. And when we put all these things together, we feel insecure and we feel that we are not appreciated as doctors in this country. And that is the reason why we are decided to bring the government to a negotiation table and so that they can tell us what is wrong and how they want to make this better.
Again, this is not the first time your association is embarking on strike. The issues seem to be a backlog of, you know, payments that should have been made before now, dating back to the previous administration. What do you think will be different with this particular strike?
The difference is this. Our people are not comfortable with the way government has been handling this issue. There is a saying that you should give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. Government made these promises just some few months ago, and I failed to keep the promise. We are not even talking about the arrears of our salaries, 2014, 2015, and 2016. It is part of our demand. But then I'm talking about the promises that we have made just recently, just some few months ago. That was in April. And government has failed to fulfill that. That means they are not serious with whatever they are doing. So that's why we have started to take this drastic action. And we plead with Nigerians to understand us. We are not happy that we have to do this, but it seems that this is the only way we have now.
Well, how have you been coping without this hazard allowance? How are your members actually been coping without the hazard allowance specifically?
It's been terrible. You can't imagine giving a doctor or any other health worker 5,000 naira as a hazard allowance with the current pandemic we have now. 5,000 naira is not worth the life of any doctor. And it is wrong for you to continue to do that. And that is what we are asking the government. Come down and negotiate with us. Tell us what you are going to pay us as a hazard allowance. So that when we continue to fight this, or we'll fight it with our whole hearts. That's the truth.
Where is the talks with the government now? Is it that it is completely stalled, or there are areas where the association and the federal government is not agreeing at all?
Well, let me start by saying that sometime in August, exactly on the 6th of August, the Ministry of Labour and Employment, led by Dr. Chris Imige, invited us to a meeting. And in that meeting, they agreed that they will recommence the payment of the June COVID inducement allowance. And we agreed in that meeting that within the next 1 or 2 weeks, that payment would have been completed. Now, they only went ahead and paid 6 centers out of over 50-something federal tertiary health institutions in the country. And we waited for them in the last 1 week, and the payment has completely stopped. So we don't see anything different, and that is why we decided to call their attention, and then they've not scheduled any meeting with us. So we are not happy. The government is not even making frantic efforts to solve this problem.
What is the way forward, basically?
The way forward is for government to call us, listen to us, understand us, and help us solve this problem once and for all. Because our mind is made up, and we don't want to continue suffering this way. As we speak now, 14 of our members are already dead. None of the family members have benefited anything from the federal government. And that is not acceptable. That is not the way it should be. So the way forward is for government to call on us. We are ready. We will listen to them. If they invite us to a meeting, we'll be present. We'll discuss and solve this matter once and for all. But for us, until they do that, we have to stay at home.
All right, Doctor, thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us on the news.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.